congratulations on Twilight.
Thank you.
Could you talk about how you got involved with the film in the first place?
Sure. I mean, it was a complete surprise. You know, we get auditions every day, and that one came in, and I was like, Twilight? Really? And, you know, I was completely nervous and thought I had no chance in the world, and then, you know, just decided someone's got to get the part, right? So, why not me?
And there you go.
Yeah. And just, I had a lot of people like praying for me and sending me good vibes, and like all my sisters and I love Twilight so much. And they got all their friends to like send me good energy, and I swear to you, I got this part because so many people were thinking of me and hoping that I did.
Okay, well, let's talk about the experience of being on set and filming the last film.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Well, as a fan, it was crazy. I was really nervous to meet everyone, and you know, I've been goo goo gaga over everyone as well, and then all of a sudden I'm joining their family, and I was really nervous, but the minute I got on set, Bill Condon came up to me right away, he dropped what he was doing, he was like, hi Marissa, welcome to set. I met everybody, people came up and introduced themselves to me, all the big stars, you know, they were just so nice, welcoming.
Good. And it's such a, like you said, it's such a big phenomenon, and you're a fan, and everybody's a fan. So have you had any sort of fan interaction already even before the movie starts?
Any what, fan interaction?
Yes.
Oh, immediately. Immediately. As soon as, like, people found out that I was cast, I don't even know how they found out I was cast, but they got pictures of me from my Facebook, and they were posting them on all the fan sites, and then the fans were finding me on Twitter, and they were being so wonderful. And the best part, or the most fascinating, is that there were people from all over the world. And from Latin America, and they were so excited that I could tweet with them in Spanish, and it was just so amazing how worldwide it is.
Now, did the cast give you any tips and tricks on how to handle this whole kind of mania around the series of films?
Uh-huh, the fandom. I mean, really, they just said embrace it, and the fans are the most lovely, amazing people, and just, you know, feed off of their love and give it back.
Very cool. And is this your first Comic Con?
It is.
And how are you enjoying it?
I love it. It's such a trip. Like I was telling you before, I hung out in San Diego a lot, and all my favorite places are now transformed into like the woods of the Brothers Grimm, and you know, the Revolution, and it's just incredible. It's better than Disneyland.
And now that you've done Twilight, that's about to come out. Where do you go from there?
Well, we've got a couple projects in the pipeline. I'm a producer as well, so I produced my own pilot presentation this past couple months. And it's a comedy, it's really funny, it's called Sweet Mary and Jane. Check it out on YouTube. The trailer, at least. We're keeping the pilot episode under wraps for now, we're shopping it around. And I got cast in the pilot episode of Animal Practice, which is going to be on NBC.
I saw that, actually.
You did?
Yes.
It's so hilarious. And Justin Kirk's in it, and Tyler Bean, and Bobby Lee, and Joanna Garcia. And my scene is with one of the tigers from The Hangover. Like, with the tiger. It's crazy.
Was it the real tiger?
The real, actual, live tiger from The Hangover. And, like, the tiger... We're running in the scene, okay? You don't want to run with a tiger necessarily.
Right.
I felt the breath and the spit of a live tiger on my cheek. And I was like, this is happening right now.
Like, all right. I need to ask about this tiger thing. Do they give you any like safety things?
They did.
Like, how does that work?
It was a big safety thing. They had two animal handlers there as well that were right around me, and they really prepped me before. So they were like, this is how you need to act, so she feels you're part of the team, you're part of the family. And they were like, don't move too fast, because then she thinks you're playing a game, and then you're the toy, and you're the bait. And so they were really, really, really
all right. Oh, good.
Really
good.
Safe. And she was very kind not to spray me, because she sprayed a couple other people.
Oh.
Just to like mark her territory. It's horrible.
So fun. Well, Animal Practice is a comedy, and then The Twilight is... So what do you feel more comfortable in? Like, what do you enjoy doing best as an actor?
You know, I enjoy the variety, because you can just step into one world, and Twilight's, it's fantasy, but it's based in reality, and there's just so many, you know, truths of life and love and relationships. And then on the other hand, it's things like Animal Practice, it's just, I mean, laughter is what makes us feel so alive, yeah? And it's just so much fun. They're completely different animals, though, like, really. It's a different skill. Comedy is all about timing, And yeah, just completely different skills, but it's fun to exercise with different muscles.
So how did you prepare for animal practice versus quite like, do you have different processes, different depending on the genre of a show or
Yeah, for animal practice, I made sure to hit the improv classes for a couple weeks before the shoot and just like, you know, get those improv muscles going because on set, in comedies, they love for you to riff, you know, like try different things and so that's what you need. I feel like that helps a lot preparing for comedy.
What has been the most surprising thing for you being part of the Twilight
Most surprising? You know what? I feel like the most surprising thing is how welcoming the original cast is. They are beyond famous, and they are just, you know, loved and adored across the world, and I was really expecting to get on set and then not even look at me. And they were so kind and so welcoming, and not only are they like that with me, but I've seen how they're like that with the fans. They care so much, and they care so much about the books and the character, and yeah, it's just wonderful.
That's good to know. And do you have like a special message that you can give your fans before the movie comes out?
Just, you know, get that all that energy going and send us your love because we're going to be sending it all back. And keep in touch with us on all of our Twitter accounts because we're all kind of sending secret messages and we'll be giving you little tips and tricks and stuff.
Can you tell us your Twitter handle?
Yes, it's Marissa_Quinn.
Great. And one final question, anything that you're really excited about checking out here at Comic-Con?
What haven't I gotten a chance to look into yet?
Or anything that you love that you have seen so far?
I'm so excited about Revolution. My friend J.D. Pardo, who is my character, my nephew in the film, is actually going to be starring in that. He's a series regular, and so the panel's coming up, and I'm just so proud of him, and I can't wait to hear all about that. Awesome.